is everyone happy with that? I mean, you touched on it. There's accidents where people want to have further input. So, if officers could bring that back to us at the appropriate time, they can generate what we've got further information. Accessible housing requirements from page 13. See, we reference the building regulations in that policy. So please, we've got a little bit of time to our them and our policy. So it was excellent to see.
And as you say, this is the one of the very rare occasions where we're allowed to use other legislation achieve what it is we're trying to get. In this case, the government has set optional standards for accessible homes, and we're allowed then the rules are optional, but the only way you can get the building control people can use it is if we have a policy. This is an area that will require further discussions with our housing colleagues. This is what we're trying to go for, and it will be subject to viability testing as well.
Okay.
So at least, I'm going to submit the second one, at least XX%. Is there any reason why I can't be 100%? Because obviously, any one of us could end up with some sort of disability, and I think it's probably sensible that nowhere homes are designed to be as accessible as possible or adaptable as possible, changing circumstances.
Well, there are two standards in the building regs. The one with the XXXs is for wheelchair housing. And you do need to take a judgment again based on the norms assessments that we have for what we can reasonably achieve. I'm being advised that this is the most expensive
development, background development. I think I'd wondered why there's a threshold of between one and three dwellings that kicks in that much. But the background development is obviously development in the background or garden it is. I'm sure Geoffrey will tell you that some houses you could probably do more than three, in which case it doesn't get covered by the background development. So why is there a threshold of houses rather than just identifying some areas clearly background? So it tells you already.
Absolutely. You know, people will be arguing all the time, so
you
This all seems to be all very, very sweetly. I'm just wondering how much it differs from HS 11 as such.
There's not much difference. I know that there's a very good unity policy for the thing that's complicated.
Extensions, if you remember, were covered in the general criteria. You opted it for it, but that's the way round into it, and it was fair to the whole. So there's a route back through it. In fairness, anything else?
I don't know quite how to phrase this, how it can go into house extensions, but I see frequently see extensions being added to existing houses. Where for simplicity the design is a gable and two pitched roofs, which brings that the point of that roof unnecessarily close to the house next door. And while we cover the terracing bit by insisting on the setback, you get an unnecessarily large roof containing nothing. There's no intention for loft conversion, or there's no opportunity for loft conversion. It often seems to be that it would be more neighbourly to have a bonnet style roof where the gable wall as the roof goes back to a foreshortened ridge.
You don't think with three doors?
I this may be in the opposite direction, shall we say. This might be a rear extension, where they're putting a bedroom out at the back, and they take the roof ridge, the whole length of the extension, where they can cut it to half the length and have a sloping rear roof form, which would then do much less shadowing to the neighbours' house, perhaps.
Self-contained flats, page 16.
In terms of new build, you frequently see where a large old house with tall brick chimneys topped by tall chimney pots is demolished and replaced by a block of flats with accommodation in the roof space. But the roof ridge is taken to the height of the original chimney pots. So you get a much more massive block than you would otherwise get. And I've always thought that was wrong. The ridge height of the new building should be the same as the genuine ridge height of the previous building, and not to the height of the chimneys plus the chimney pots.
At the end of the day, it's all back. Therefore, people come back to
in terms of the in terms of where the policy is, that's, I think that's what we're more interested in, like where it will sit. Again, hopefully the minutes will reflect that he's still thinking about it.
Yeah.
Which is fine, which is fine. It's an issue that needs to be addressed.
What does it say?
We want to see it addressed somewhere in the
seems on the face of it fine. It just, I mean, so say, top of page 19, two, results in a detrimental change in the character of the area, and three, cause nuisance to neighbours, neighbouring uses, particularly in respect of noise and disturbance on street parking and deliveries by the vehicle. Now, I can think of a car showroom at Police Station Foulkes, which was converted to a very nice but the trouble was that the deliveries started arriving at 5:30 in the morning, so it was considerably detrimental. Although I think it was a big lorry which had to back it to the site as well. Obviously conditions can be put on, but you know, the policy might be better to start off in these situations if it's in a primary residential area.
I wasn't aware that
targets to have their little bathroom expresses and all the western beds, which might feel available. They would say they were small, they would say they're not so small. We would still operate on Monday just in time. I appreciate Tyler would say, I mean, cause nuisance, particularly especially Moses says, look, that delivery is my vehicle. Should we expand that to say we're expecting, in other words, particularly between the hours of? Something that we would normally condition, because we're being asked to move away from conditions as much as we can, because it's an unsatisfying demand, we all just do a few of them. You know, if it's not easy policy, we're not trying to control too much by conditions.
Just a point of information, reversing alarms are legal to use before 7 o'clock. So if you've got the lorries using reversing alarms at 5, I think it calls the police as another.
I think beyond that also the things have been delivered in trolleys on wheels, crashed off the back of the wagon, down the lifts, bang, bang, bang.
Yes.
Absolute character, and
the bit in the box is the policy, the one with all these other paragraphs.
That's just supporting the text to the policy, and again, that's something that we could be accused of putting some guidance forward outside of the policy book.
Yeah, because I think it
provides
the decision.
As I said, a lot of these things are the current UDP that's being brought forward, and we can give some thoughts about that. But on the face of it, is the idea of a scenario. It's whether to choose.
Do you think about that being the case? If not, then it seems redundant.
Just saying, we used to have what we called justification for each policy, didn't we? So in a way, this is just saying where we're coming from. Isn't it, really?
Page 20, specialist housing.
Could you put your microphone on, please? Thank you very much.
Criteria, what would take precedence? I'm just trying to
we discover that we've lost a plan because we've done it wrong and we've been able to have that. These are not a once in a lifetime, you know, and they're not on the 15-year. Your strategic ones are, but if you've got something on that special thousand, then you just go back to the chair. I mean, they'd have to go through a process of consultation agreements, but I think I might say, my agenda, we should again, I can't remember now what the subject is, I'm not going to try and work through as much. I'll again send an email out with my initial observations. Some members have raised questions with ideas. Go, okay.